Before we dive in, let's first understand the purpose of this service. Read Data by Identifier service allows the client to request data record values from the server identified by one or more data identifiers. In the last video, we had a look into details of control DTC setting, service 85. Let's have a look into the next diagnostic service, that's Read Data by Identifier, service 22. Before we dive in, let's first understand the purpose of this service. Read Data by Identifier service allows the client to request data record values from the server identified by one or more data identifiers. The data can include ECU identification numbers, analog input and output signals, digital input and output signals, internal operational data, system status information, etc. The format and definition of the data record shall be vehicle manufacturer or system supplier specific. Multiple data identifiers can be requested simultaneously, considering the server limit and vehicle manufacturer and supplier agreement. With this understanding, let's dive into the request definition of the service. Firstly, we have Read Data by Identifier Request SID, which maps to value 22, followed by one or more data identifier, which shall support value in the range of 0 to FF. The data identifier identifies the server data record that are being requested by the client. The service does not support a subfunction parameter. Let's look into the positive response. Positive response contains Read Data by Identifier SID, that's 62, followed by data identifier, same as the request data identifier value, which is then followed by data record identified by the data identifier. Following are the NRCs supported. NRC 13, which is incorrect message length or invalid format. The NRC shall be sent if the length of the request message is invalid or the client exceeds the maximum number of data identifiers allowed to be requested at a time. NRC 14, that's response too long. The NRC shall be sent if the total length of the response message exceeds the limit of the underlying transport protocol. NRC 22, that's condition not correct. The NRC shall be sent if the operating conditions of the server are not met to perform the required actions. NRC 31, that's request out of range. This NRC shall be sent if none of the requested data identifier values are supported by the device or none of the requested data identifier are supported in the current session or the requested dynamic defined data identifier has not been assigned yet. NRC 33, that security access denied. The NRC shall be sent if at least one of the data identifier requested is secured and the server is not in an unlocked state. Diagram shows the order of evaluation of different NRCs. Firstly, we have NRC 13, checked for min and max length of the request, which is then followed by check on the support of the service in the current active session, which in case if it fails, leads to NRC 31. Next, you see the security check, which confirms if the secure access is required for the service. And if the ECU does not have the right access, then check fails with the NRC 33. Followed by check on the precondition, which has to be fulfilled before executing the service, which in case if it fails, leads to NRC 22. While providing the response, the total length of the response exceeds the expected length, then this would lead to NRC 14. If all the above checks are true, then the positive response for the service shall be provided. Let's look into our first example, where a single 2-byte data identifier FN90, that's WIN identification service, is sent by the client. The client request shall be as follows. Then the server shall respond with the data as follows. Next, let's look into our second example, where the data identifier 010A and 0110 services are sent. The client request shall be as follows, and the server shall respond with data as follows. With this, we have had a detailed look into the data by identifier 22 service. In the upcoming session, we'll have a look into read memory by address 23 service. Thank you.